here in the Alaska Garden. I'm with UAF Cooperative Extension Service and Tanana Chiefs Conference, and today I'm going to be talking all about high tunnels. So I'm here at a high tunnel here in Fairbanks, Alaska. This is a 30 by 72 foot Gothic style high tunnel. High tunnels are great because they extend our short growing season and also increase the temperatures for the growing season inside. They're low-cost structures relative to a greenhouse, and they're actually considered temporary structures too. So this one's in a power line, and that would not be possible if you had a greenhouse. So per square foot, they're pretty cost-effective. High tunnels are usually manually ventilated or passively ventilated, and you don't usually have grow lights inside high tunnels or cement flooring. You're also growing right in the ground usually in high tunnels. So this one has two different sizes of doors. One is big enough to actually have a tractor go inside and till. You can also till with a rototiller. And usually in greenhouses, you're growing in containers or in raised beds. And so if you need to replace the soil, you have to manually carry in that soil and replace it. So that right there saves a lot of time as well for a high tunnel. So other styles of high tunnels are Quonset hut shaped, and those ones can be the cheapest structure, but they don't shed the snow quite as easily, and it's harder to go too wide with that type of structure too. But the nice thing about Quonset style is that it keeps the warm air closer to the plants. With the Gothic style, the air rises to the peak, and so it's not quite as warm low down. But the Gothic style sheds the snow a little bit easier than the Quonset hut style. It's also easier to work on the sides because you have more headroom to work, and so you can stand up a little bit easier. Another style that's actually considered a high tunnel for the purposes of the Natural Resource Conservation Service is a round type greenhouse style. And that's really good for very windy conditions, but it's difficult to grow things in a round, in round paths. So I mentioned the Natural Resource Conservation Service, or NRCS, and they've got a great program that can help you with the costs of the high tunnels. It's part of their environmental incentive program to protect soil and water. So let's go ahead and go inside this high tunnel. So it's fall here in Fairbanks, and so you immediately feel the temperature difference inside. The temperature differences in high tunnels can vary quite a lot throughout the day as well as throughout the summer. And so you can have very dramatic temperature changes quite quickly from, you know, say 8 a.m. to noon in the morning when the sun is highest, and temperatures can rise pretty dramatically if the sun is out versus if it's cloudy. And this high tunnel actually has two layers of plastic, and a blower is used to force air in between those layers, which adds quite a bit more additional insulation. Another thing you could do too to raise the temperature is use a combination of season extension techniques. So you could use plastic mulch inside. You could also use a low tunnel, which is basically plastic covering just one row of plants. And you can use any number of other combinations. The more layers of plastic that you add, you are going to cut down on your light transmittance. And so say if you add two layers versus one layer of plastic, you're gonna cut down your light transmittance by about 10 to 15%. As the plastic ages, usually the plastic, this is 6 mil greenhouse plastic, this will last, it's warranted to last 4 years. As it gets older though, and you have more dirt on the plastic, you're also cutting down your light transmittance a little bit. So these high tunnels, they come in a kit. This one cost about $7,000, but it was also $7,000 for shipping. And then the end walls were built separately, and you can do any number of custom configurations for your end walls. I really like this design of this one with the door for walking in, as well as the door that's large enough for the tractor to go in. So the high tunnel extends your season quite a bit. You might be growing in here by about mid-April and as late as October or even November. And again, that's partly because this high tunnel has two layers of plastic where you can force the air into it. And some very frost-sensitive crops will probably be the first to die, but of course you could grow cool season crops even later than some of your warm season crops in these structures. And not only can you grow longer, things will be more productive during the season because the temperatures are higher. So you can see there's melons growing in here, tomatoes. Got quite a few ripe ones here, cucumbers, and strawberries. So growing warm season crops in a high tunnel makes a lot of sense because they like the warmer temperatures and they need longer seasons for maturing. But if you're a farmer, you also want to consider the higher value crops. So you could of course grow broccoli in here, but it may not like the warmer temperatures and it's not a particularly high value crop. So it probably doesn't make sense to grow that in a high tunnel unless you want to push the season. So some of the benefits of the high tunnels, as I said, you may be increasing your temperatures 5 to 10 degrees, depending on the time of day and the season. But you're also protecting your crops from too much rain, from wind, and you're increasing the humidity inside the environment too. You're also protecting from hail and unseasonable frosts. So if you experience, say, a mid-season frost in some areas of Alaska, it may kill all of your garden in the middle of summer. Or even if you experience an early frost, but the temperatures don't drop overall, you can still extend your season quite a bit and you have some protection against those unpredictable weather conditions. Some people even grow cut flowers in high tunnels, and that's a good way to go because cut flowers are very sensitive to hail or rain and that type of thing. So, and for your vegetable crops, when you use drip irrigation, you minimize the splashing of water, and so it keeps your crops really clean. So you have to do less washing, and it keeps the moisture down on the leaves as well, which can minimize some of the pest and disease that you would otherwise see with the increased moisture. On the other hand, that can be a challenge with growing in a high tunnel, is when you get later into the season and you're trying to keep the temperatures as high as possible and conserve your heat, you can have quite a bit of moisture buildup in the high tunnel. And without a lot of active ventilation, it can be challenging to mitigate that moisture. So let's go ahead and go down the row here and look a little more closely at what's growing in here. We've got snap beans in here. That's another warm season crop. Cucumbers and tomatoes are usually grown in greenhouses, and so in the high tunnel you're able to grow them in here and have a lot more growing space than you would have in a greenhouse at a much lower cost. And another thing that's done here is when strawberries are being grown, these are grown in old gutters, and you can see there are three layers of strawberries. So this is a way that space can really be saved with growing these strawberries. And strawberries, cucumbers, tomatoes, they're high value crops. So if you are a farmer, those are great ones to grow in your high tunnel. You could also grow things like lettuce or cool season crops and try to be the first one to the market with those greens and get a higher price as well. But you can see here, this one has bolted And in the high tunnel, the temperatures could be too warm for some of those cold season crops like lettuce as well. Another great crop to grow in high tunnels are peppers. They do really well inside the high tunnel. Usually bell peppers or sweet peppers are really difficult to grow outside here in Alaska. And of course you can grow them in a greenhouse as well, but you have a lot more space here in the high tunnel. So we've got a couple different varieties here. Carmen, this one's Lipstick, and we've got some hot peppers as well. And you can see they're ripening and it's not even September. And usually they need a growing season that's too long for Alaska, and especially here in Fairbanks. So today we've been talking about high tunnels. Check out our other videos. I'm Heidi Rader here in the Alaska Garden. Thanks for joining.